Miami, Florida, today we get to enjoy the temperature-controlled atmosphere under the roof of Lone Depot Park. Joey Wendell digs in now. He will lead this one off today. This is hit high in the air out toward left center. Dickerson's there, and he hauls it in for the first out of the inning. Up next for the Rays, Willy Adames. Lifetime against this pitcher. He's 0 for 5. Lofted in the air out toward right center. After it is Marte. That's a hit, their first of the new season.
That's the cat and mouse of the game right there. You find yourself count leverage, you think you're getting a heater, he throws an off-speed pitch and you're still able to execute, that fires me up right there.
Into the box now, Austin Meadows. Hit hard up the middle, and that gets through for a one-out base hit.
Hey, a little top-of-the-order lightning right here, Dan. The second and third guys in the batting order throw knocks out there, and now you're staring a monster in the face.
Hero, this is just what you don't want to face as a pitcher, right? You get the two- and three-hole guys up, and all of a sudden now it's four, five, and six. Yeah.
Side is retired as they make the play. Now at the plate here is John Birdie. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. Swing and a ground ball to third. And a good throw gets him one gun. Up next from Miami, Miguel Rojas. Hit on the ground toward the left. Throw gets him at first, and that was a magnificent play.
That ball almost got through the hole right there. Could have been a seeing eye single. Love to step in a dive to his left. That's actually a harder play. It's almost easier to go backhand when you're reacting at third base. Nice play right there. Nice angle to the baseball.
Lifted in the air to center. A Rosarena gets under it and makes the catch. Here comes the 1-2. Popped up. Aguilar is there. And he hauls it in for the first out of the inning.
That is good.
So the next to the plate for Tampa Bay, G-Man Choi. And he comes back with a fastball, 1-2 now. No score here as we play inning number 2. A bouncer to the left side. Throw on to first will get him. Score at 5-3 on the putout, though it looked more like a 6-3 ground ball. Nevertheless, there are two away now. And now in the box, Michael Brusso. He'll work on keeping this top of the second alive. Got him swinging, and that will end the inning. So here's the cleanup hitter for Miami, Adam Duvall. Lifetime versus this pitcher. Just a couple of matchups, no hits in two at-bats. Here comes the 1-2.
If he's going to execute that curveball, and that's the first one of the day, if he's going to execute it like that, be on the lookout for that one. That's going to be a big pitch for him today.
High fly ball out to straightaway center. A Rosarena is there, and he has it for the first out.
That is good.
Ready now for the Marlins. This is Aguilar.
Aguilar.
Looked like he was on that one, but it's 1-2. Bottom of the second here with no score. Comes back with the cut fastball for strike three called, and there are two down.
Yeah, as they say, there's a hole in his swing in that location, so a good job there of exploiting that. That can be real hard for some guys to overcome when teams start figuring out what locations you just can't handle.
Wendell makes the catch to end the inning. Now into the box, Francisco Mejia, as we are all set to begin the third inning in this one. And oh, that gets him on the mound. And they'll have no play as he reaches first base safely. At the plate, Ryan Yarbrough. Now a bunt attempt here. To second for one. Well, he'll put this in his pocket and be content with just the one out. And that'll bring up Joey Wendell. Flew out in his only at-bat so far. Line drive to center field. In there, the base hit.
A lot of traffic hitting the base pass. First and second with one out. I know you're looking for a double play ball, Dan.
No question about it. I think one of the things you like to do on a pitcher is try to jump on him early before he gets settled in. So far, so good. First and second looks like a pitch.
This one gets through, and that could bring in a run. And the run will score as the Rays cash in on an early 1-0 lead.
Boy, that has to feel good as a hitter, D-Row. You get that base hit to give your team the lead. You have to feel good when you get down to first base.
Yeah, it's just a nice approach. You see him turn to his boys right there and get fired up with the dugout. 100%. Not trying to do too much. Able to quiet the moment down, center himself, and come through in a big spot.
Aguilar has to shade his eyes from the sun, but he stays with it for round number two. So now here is Brandon Lau, and they're runners at the corners now. Now a swing and a softly hit ground ball. A 1-2 pitch. High fly ball out to straightaway center. And he will make the catch just shy of the track, and the inning is over. Rays will settle for just the one. Now to the plate, Brian Anderson. Lifetime in this matchup. He's hitless in six tries. Oh, and this is hit high and deep out to left. Solo shot here to left. First home run of the campaign for him. And with it, the Marlins are back even now at 1-1. At the plate now, Jorge Alfaro. To short. Adames picks it up. On the first, so a good bounce back pitch there as he gets the ground ball for the first out. Coming to the plate now, the pitcher for the Marlins, Pablo Lopez. Hit down the line at first, fielded cleanly, and he'll step on first himself for the out. Back to the top of the Miami lineup now, and stepping in, John Birdie, grounded out at his last at bat.
Yeah, I understand that, Matty, but this guy's got burner wheels down the first baseline.
Well, the left fielder's on it, and that retires the side. But a run scores in the inning, and that'll have to be good enough. Welcome back to Miami as we check in with Heidi Watney. New inning set to get underway, and next will be a speed threat in the form of outfielder Randy Arozarena. A ball and two strikes now. Had to wait back on the changeup, and he did a good job just to make contact. 50th pitch of the game on its way. Grounded softly down the line toward first. And they will he's in there. A very close play. And it looks now like they want some time to review that one. The call on the field was safe, but it was definitely a bang-bang play.
Yeah, close play right there, no doubt. And we're going to have to take another look. And that's just tough to tell. We're going to have to see what they decide what to do with this one.
Stepping in now, G-Man Choi. Yeah. Fastball taken, but that gets the zone for a strike.
One and two.
One out, nobody on. And that is swung on and missed. He's down on strikes. And the first two are retired here to begin inning number four. Next, here is Michael Brasso, struck out in his first at-bat. 1-2 now as that one's fouled off. Still a ball and two strikes. Anderson trying to get there. One run, five hits, and no errors for Tampa Bay so far. Ball two.
Pretty good breaking ball to lay off of right there. If I'm pitching, I might think this guy might be sitting on something off speed.
Fouled off. The 2-2 one more time.
Three and two.
Hey, this guy's a hard guy to put away. He's fouling off some tough pitches. 2-2 count, and he just seems to keep hanging right in there.
Scooped up. Onto the back. Back with it is Aguilar, and that'll retire the side. Ready to go in the bottom of the fourth. And coming forward now is the shortstop, Miguel Rojas. 2-2. Tough curveball that time, but he's able to make a little contact to keep this at-bat going. He's ready with the 2-2 pitch.
We got a full count.
Well, you don't see it all that often, but this might be a good time for a 3-2 change. If he can locate it, it's nearly impossible to hit.
Grounded to the right. He's got it. Throws in time, and that's out number one.
Up next to the Marlins.
Digging in next will be Starling Marte. Flied out in his first at-bat, so making 0 for 1 so far. And a 3-2 full count to Starling Marte. Fouled away. The 3-2 one more time. Eighth pitch of the at-bat coming up. Line to the right side. And that is through into right field for a single.
How frustrating is that, Dan? He tries to bury something in with two strikes, and this guy's able to put bat on baseball and find a way to hit a soft liner to the opposite field.
You know, sometimes you have to tip your cap. That inside-out swing as a pitcher, you think you've thrown a good pitch, but sometimes as a hitter, they put a good swing on it and still ends up for a base hit.
Now the 3-2 pitch. Hit hard back up the middle. Reined in. There's one. Relay to first in time, and just like that, the side. Digging in, the switch hitter, Francisco Mejia. He'll start off the fifth in this one. Lined hard to center field. Marte is right there, one down.
Now batting, the pitcher.
So here now's the pitcher, Ryan Yarbrough, reached by way of a fielder's choice his first time around. Here's a little chopper up the middle, scooped up. Throw in time at first for out number two. So it's back to the top of the order now. And digging in next will be Joey Wendell. That's lifted the other way out to left. And no trouble for him as he makes the catch to end the inning. Welcome back for the bottom of the fifth. Here's Heidi Watney. So now to the plate, Jesus Aguilar. First time up, he went down looking. 3-2 pitch. On the ground to the left side. And a base hit, so the leadoff man is on to begin the inning. Into the box, Corey Dickerson. Loud contact for Dickerson, and a ball headed to deep right field. And that ball will stay fair, and it's gone, a home run.
There's still some game left to be played, but that one swing could end up being a deciding factor in this one.
So now to the plate, Brian Anderson. High fly ball out to straightaway center. A Rosarena has to roam straight back, but he has it for the first out. Next up, Jorge Alfaro. He's 0 for 1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. hard on the ground at first. And he'll take it to the bag himself for the out. Next to hit will be the pitcher, Pablo Lopez. He bounced out last time up. Hit in the air down the right field line. Long run for the right fielder. He's there to track it down, and that'll end the inning. But two in the inning for the Marlins, thanks to the top half of the sixth about to get started, and stepping up as the shortstop, Willy Adames.
This is where the pressure starts to build a little bit on an offense. It's not late enough. I mean, you don't have to start panicking right now, but this is where you're looking for someone to light a spark to get back in this game.
And he fouls this one off. Pulled pretty badly there as he reaches to poke this one foul. And it's fouled away. And a changeup swung on and missed for the first out. So the next to bat will be Austin Meadows. He was retired after popping out in his last at bat. Into the corner and slicing foul. The next 3-2. Chopper to short. Right to him. And there are two away now. Next to bat will be the Tampa Bay cleanup hitter, Brandon Lau. Flew out last time up.
Almost, Matty. Almost went deep his last AB. Certainly just missed it. With this guy's big power, he's feeling pretty good at the dish. Look for him to try and get on something and drive it out of the yard this AB.
Chop weakly to the left. Nearly got the inside, but ruled a ball.
I really like watching righty throw that cutter in on lefty's hands like that. This one was
a swing and a miss. That retires the side, and that will do it. Bottom of the sixth inning now, and set to go is the second baseman, John Birdie. Right side. He's got it. On to first, but it's too late as the first base umpire says they just missed getting him at the bag. Into the box now, Miguel Rojas. That one's down around the knees, taken for a strike.
Hey, that's a quality take right there. He knows the pitcher's trying.
And he tries to go to a knee to block it, but it's by him down the right field line. And he's safe.
It's so important, Mark, to start to make quality pitches. And if you don't, this is what can happen. Two batters, two base hits, first and third, nobody out.
Yeah, and you just got to prepare yourself as an offensive player. You're just trying to get the runner in from third. You can't worry about creating a monster inning. Do your job.
And this is swung on and missed. And, boy, they took care of a key man there. One away. Stepping in next, Adam Duvall. No hits in two trips to the plate for him in the ballgame. We're in the sixth inning here in a 3-1 ballgame. Fouled off. Another one sent foul. The next 1-2 pitch. And he looks at a sinker for a called third strike, and now there are two gone. Big spot here. Runners at the corners, two gone. And up next will be the power-hitting first baseman, Big Jesus Aguilar. Diego Castillo is out from the bullpen now as he'll get the call here on opening day. Swing and a miss on the pitch outside. 1-2 now.
Yeah, guys, he's got so much respect for this guy's fastball. You could tell he was out in front on that slider. I think he goes to the well one more time with that pitch.
And another foul ball. The
Three.
Slider freezes him at the plate. A called third strike, and the inning comes to Anthony Bass is out from the bullpen now as he'll get the call here on opening day. Seventh inning ready to roll, and that'll bring up the outfielder, Randy Arozarena. Here's the 1-2. Fouled away. The next 1-2 pitch. Line drive to left. Dickerson is there, and he makes the catch for the out.
Now batting, the first baseman.
One out now in the Tampa Bay seventh, and that brings up the corner infielder, G-Man Choi. The 2-2. And this is lined hard to deep left. Dickerson is going to get there as he backs up to put it away, and there are two gone now. And stepping in, Michael Brasso. He was retired via the ground ball last time up. Lifted in the air out to center field. Marte is under it, and he makes the catch for out. Last half of the seventh here, and standing in is the veteran outfielder, Corey Dickerson. Popped him up. Mejia waits on it, looks it into his glove, and there's one gone. Anderson stride it again, and before he takes his cuts here, let's flash you back to the third inning. This was just a solo shot, but it definitely helped get this offense going. Swing and a ball hard hit toward deep right. And that ball gets down out near the wall and should be extra bases. Not in time, and he's in there with a double.
That was a great job of driving that ball. Extending his arms very well, was able to get it over the right fielder's head. One hopping it off the wall for an easy double. That's one of those solid hits that you don't even feel coming off the bat.
And that's the second out. Now to bat, Anthony Bass. He's newly entered into the ballgame, so this will be his first trip to the plate here in inning number seven. High in the air out toward shallow right. And Meadows makes the catch for out number three. Marlins all set for the start of the inning, and digging in is the switch hitting catcher, Francisco Mejia. A 1-2 count to the Rays catcher. And that's into the corner, a foul ball and right. That's lifted the other way out to left. Dickerson's there. And that's the first out of the inning. Yandy Diaz will grab a bat hit for the pitcher here. The 1-1. Hit to third. Reined in time to first, and there are two away. To the top of the lineup, stepping in, Joey Wendell. Quickly down to their final four outs here tonight. And the inning will continue as that's through for a two-out hit.
Nice execution right there, Dan. Kept his front shoulder in, kept his hands inside the baseball, and ripped the base hit up the middle.
And if you're a pitcher right there, you can't get discouraged. Sometimes, even when you make a good pitch, the ball is going to find a hole somewhere. That one right up the middle.
Grounded to short. Scooped up. Throw in the dirt, but a good scoop. Saves an error as the side. Now at the plate is John Birdie, and he'll start out the bottom of the eighth inning. And a fastball swung on and hit to second. He's got it, and he will whip this one over to first in time for the out. Next to hit is Miguel Rojas. Last time through was a base hit. 2-2 pitch is fouled away. Into the windup and the pitch. Grounded up the first baseline. But a foul ball as it holds it 2-2. Pitch on the way. Hit to first. And he'll take it to the bag himself for the out. Next, it'll be Starling Marte. He's working on a 1-for-3 thus far. Count moves to a ball and two strikes now. Eighth inning of this low-scoring affair. 3-1 our score. Frozen for strike three, and that retires the side. Miami down in all set to start the ninth in this one, and next it'll be the outfielder, Austin Meadows. Swinging a ball hit on the ground, but this will get foul. It's a ball and two strikes. Pulled toward right center field. After it is Marte, but he won't have a play. This is down and into the gap. And the Rays strike quickly here in the inning. It's a leadoff double.
That's exactly what they needed. Down by two runs, the leadoff man puts himself in scoring position with the tying run coming to play. The temptation for the next batter is it.
There's a swing and a ball hit in the air, and a ball that he got every stitch of, as that one, without a doubt, is gone.
And some guys just have a knack for the dramatic. He comes up in a big spot and just cranks one out of here to even the score.
And this is going to get down for what should be extra bases. And there's your potential go-ahead run. And your go-ahead run is in at second base with nobody out. He's got himself a double. G-Man Choi the next to hit. It's been a rough go of things at the plate for him so far, but his guys were looking for him to change that right here. Now it goes the other way, and he got a lot of it high and deep to left center field. Catch made out there in left center as the runner may tag from second. And he is in there at third as the possible go-ahead score. At the plate, Michael Russo. And now a bunt attempt here as he gets this one down. And they'll just tag him out along the first base line. Next to stand in is Francisco Mejia. For his career in this matchup, not a big sample size, 0-for-1. Hit in the air to center field. Marte is there now to put this one away for the third out as they'll strand that potential go-ahead run at third base. Rays get a couple as you take another look at the two. Now the skipper's on his way out toward the home plate area, and I believe that means we're going to have a double switch here. Brendan McKay will come on to pitch now as he'll move into the eighth spot in the lineup on the double switch here. Mike Zunino is into the ballgame as well as he'll slide into the pitcher's spot, hitting ninth now on the double switch. Rosarena is on the warning track as he hauls it in for a loud out number one.
Up next.
Ready now is Jesus Aguilar. He's got a hit in three at-bats to this point. Now a ground ball and a chance for Adames at short. Fielded cleanly on to first, and there are two down. Next, it'll be Corey Dickerson. He got under one and popped out his last time up.
Yeah, I don't mind him trying to drive the ball in the air, but he can't collapse the backside, and that's exactly what he did in his last at-bat. Look for him to stay a little taller and keep that upper half a little bit more over him.
Skied in the air to straightaway left. Left fielder giving chase. He makes the catch. We are headed to extra inning. Runner at second now. Nobody out. And that'll bring up the catcher, Mike Zunino. Hit in the air to shallow center. Here comes Marte. He gets there to make the play for the first out of the inning. Throw back to second, and that's a double play. So the batting order turns over now and set to go Joey Wendell. Lifetime against this particular arm. Not a big sample. is 0 for 1. Throw over to Aguilar at first. He'll take care of him to end the. Garrett Cooper will be summoned now to be the pinch runner. And now, Ryan Anderson. And he's got a chance to bring in the winning run. Question is whether they'll even pitch to him. And there's one away. Digging in next, Jorge Alfaro. He's gone hitless to this point.
Not a great game up to this point, but none of that would matter if he could come through right here. A chance to be the hero.
Meadows moving back. He makes the catch, and the runner from second will tag and hit for third. The relay, and they will not get him at third. He's in there with two away as the winning run. Chad Wallach will be called upon here to hit with the game on the line. He set the 3-2. Now this is lined into right center. He comes through. And they're going to walk off with a 4-3 victory.
Well, the way things unfolded, you kind of had a sense that this thing was going to end in dramatic fashion. And that's exactly what happened. A walk-off for the win. Wow.
Here now is our final line score for this afternoon.